New questions are being raised over the validity of a traffic stop by Chicago police that ended in a deadly shooting.
Glenn Marshall joins us live from the newsroom to explain. Good morning, Glenn.
Hey, good morning, guys. Now, we've heard from the person who oversees CPD, COPA, and the police board during an unrelated meeting held in Morgan Park. This was last night, but she says she's not jumping to conclusions, even though COPA has revealed one officer fired his weapon at least 50 times during that traffic stop.
We've seen a video, and we haven't seen all of the rest of the investigation that has to occur.
Words coming from the commissioner of the Community Commission for Public Safety and Accountability, Yvette Loizon, is urging the public to have patience after body camera footage was released showing police shooting and killing Dexter Reed.
We like to think that the video tells the whole story. I can promise you the video never tells the whole story.
The video shows the moments four tactical plainclothes officers fired 96 times at Dexter Reed after COPA says he was shot first, wounded an officer. Sources with WGN are saying 10 shell casings were found inside Reed's vehicle and are believed to have been fired by the 26-year-old. COPA is saying the officers were stopping Reed because he wasn't wearing a seatbelt. However, a newly obtained memo sent by COPA's chief administrator to CPD Superintendent Larry Snelling raises concerns about the validity of that stop. It says the available evidence calls into question the veracity of this account. Specifically, COPA is uncertain how the officers could have seen the seatbelt violation given their location relative to Reed's vehicle and the dark tints on the vehicle's window. Reed's name has been redacted from this memo. Loizon notes part of this investigation is hearing what officers have to say.
The police officers have to be interviewed so that they can provide their account of what happened. To the best of my knowledge, none of those officers have been interviewed to date.
The shooting has received a response from Governor J.B. Pritzker calling the incident tragic.
I think we're going to have to see a full investigation, and I hope that that'll be done very quickly so that we can figure out what, if any, changes need to be made.
The goal is to ensure that there's an independent evaluation by multiple layers of accountability bodies so that, you know, hopefully when it's all said and done, we've gotten it right.
In the meantime, COPA has requested that CPD relieve the four officers of their police powers while this investigation continues. Back to you guys in the studio.